نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام ميم. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. نزل عليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه وأنزل التوراة والإنجيل من قبل هدى للناس وأنزل الفرقان. إن الذين كفروا بآيات الله لهم عذاب شديد والله عزيز ذو انتقام. إن الله لا يخفى عليه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء. هو الذي يصوركم في الأرحام كيف يشاء. لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى. اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا، وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وآناء النهار، واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين. آمين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. With the name of Allah, I am hoping and invoking His help in every respect. Tonight we are starting the third surah of the Quran, that is Surah Al Imran. As I told you in the introductory lecture, most of the surahs of the Quran are in the form of pairs. This is the rule with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has created everything in pairs. وَمِن كُلِّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقْنَا زَوْجَيْنِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Everything we have created in pairs. We find in the Quran, although we don't think it is something created, but this rule, you know, is so firm that even in Quran we find that the surahs are in pairs. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given one name to these two surahs, Az-Zahrawain. Az-Zahra, the most shining. So these are the two most shining surahs of the Quran according to that hadith, Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Al-Imran. And you find that the Quran ends with Al-Mu'awwadhatayn, the two surahs which teach us ta'awwuz, how to take refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq, qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. Subject matter is the same, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has divided it into two, so that there is a pair, Mu'awwadhatayn, two surahs which are teaching us ta'awwuz, how to do ta'awwuz. You will find that just as in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the first section, there are some fundamental rules about Quran. Who can really benefit from Quran? هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ إِلَى الْآخِرِ. In the same way, you will find in the first section of Surah Al Imran a very basic discussion about the understanding of Quran. In the same way, Surah Al Baqarah, as we read last night, it ended with a very big dua, prayer. In the same way, you will find that this Surah Al Mubarakah will also end. We have just, you know, recited the Imam in the second rakah of Surah Al Isha, that prayer, a very long prayer, which comes in the last section of Surah Al Imran. Then again, like Surah Al Baqarah, it is also divisible into two parts. And here the parts are nearly equal, absolutely equal, I should say. Because the surah consists of 200 ayat divided into 20 sections, 20 rukus. So on the average, every ruku contains 10 ayat. The first part of the surah consists of 101 ayat. And the second part of the surah consists of 99 ayat. 10 rukus in the first part, 10 rukus in the second part. Again, just like Surah Al-Baqarah, the first part is divisible into three sections. And in the middle section, as there was the direct address to Yahud, to the Jews, to Bani Israel, Ya Bani Israel, Azkuru Ni'mati Allati An'amtu Alaykum Wa Anni Faddaltukum Ala Al-Alamin. In the same way, you will find in Surah Al-Imran, the address is to the other group of the people of the book, and they are the Christians. So Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wa salam, his personality, his life, his mission, his da'wah, it has been discussed in that middle section of the first half of the surah. So there are many other points of similarity between these two surahs, but we shall inshallah see as we go through them. Otherwise we'll take much time in this introductory lecture. So now we begin. Alif Lam Mim, again a point of similarity. Surah Al-Baqarah also started with Alif Lam Mim, and this Surah Mubarakah is also starting with Alif Lam Mim. I told you there are six surahs of the Quran in total which begin with these letters, Alif Lam Mim. Two are here in the beginning, and these are the Madani surahs. Four are, you will find them later, in the 21st section, in the 21st part of the Quran. That is Surah Al-Ankabut, Surah Al-Rum, Surah Al-Sajdah, Surah Al-Luqman. They are Makki surahs, and they also start with Alif Lam Mim. Alif Lam Mim, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. These words we have read in Ayatul Kursi. Allah is He, that there is no God except Him. And He is al-hayy, He is living. His life is His own, not given by anybody else. Ever living Al-Qayyum, and He is sustaining and maintaining the whole of existence. Himself, He is self-sufficient, but the rest of the existence needs His support and sustenance to exist. Al-Hayyul Qayyum. Nazzala alayka al-kitaba bil-haq. He has sent down this book, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with truth. And bilhaq means at different places differently. With truth and with a true purpose. It has been sent down with a purpose, not without a purpose. Musaddiqan lima bayna yadayh. And it has come confirming those scriptures which are present before it. Quran confirms Torah, that this was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Moses alayhi salatu wa salam. Quran confirms Injil, that it was given to Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wa salam by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa anzala Torah wal Injil, and He Himself had sent down Torah and Injil min qabl, before this Quran. Hudan linnas, those two books as well as this book, they have been sent for guidance for humanity. Hudan linnas wa anzala al-furqan, and He has sent down the criterion with which you can differentiate between evil and good. You can differentiate between false and real. You can differentiate between what is correct and what is wrong. Inna al-lazina kafaru bi ayati Allahi lahum azabun shadeed. Whosoever belies and denies the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for them there is a very painful torment, a punishment which is very painful. Wallahu azizun zintiqam. Allah is almighty, all-powerful, He has all the authority. And He is who takes revenge also. Zintiqam,